Hello everyone, welcome. Today we are going to start a new tutorial, and in this tutorial we are going to make this cable. This is a USB cable. It contains from four parts. This is the first part, and this is the second part, and this is the third part, and final fourth part is here. Let's get started from this part, and as you can see, we can imagine or we can guess that this 1 centimeter width. So we will go in the top view and start from a plane. This plane, firstly we will make the length or the units to be metric, and as you can see, this plane is 2 meter by 2 meter, and let's say in the x-axis will be 3 centimeter and in the y-axis will be 1 centimeter, and as you can see, it's very small. So click the dot. So as you can see, we can enable the screencast case and make this to be, let's say it will be like this, and as you can see, it's here 3 centimeter by 1 centimeter. Alright, so after that, let's say it will be 1 centimeter and 2, so 12 millimeter by 30 millimeter, and the thickness, let's say the thickness will be 4 millimeter extrude in the axis, let's say 4 millimeter. 4 is high, so let's say 3, and we will now divide. Select this and extrude by 2 millimeter. And I will select this and move like this. And after that, I will select this face and shift D to duplicate and separate by selection. Let's make the origin to geometry, scale shift Z 0.8 and scale on Y 0.4. After that, I will scale like this and move in Y axis, making a geometry by extruding in Z axis. And after that, I will apply the rotation and the scale. Then I will make an array modifier. This array modifier will be, let's say it will be in the y axis, and let's say it will be 3, and make 4 so now let's move to the next part, which is this cable itself, or the connection. I am here in the top view, and I will add a plane, or we can select this plane and shift D in X, separate by selection, and scale in Y axis, make the origin to the geometry and apply rotation and scale. Let's move it like this, and as you can see, it's high, so we can move to the right place, and we can select all and scale to the y axis. We can now move this edge to be here, and we can extrude, let's say it will be 2 millimeters. So let's move to the next part. So in this part, we have this second part, which has the logo. So we can start by selecting these two faces and shift D in X axis and separate by selection. After that, we can, let's say, the origin to the geometry, and we can now extrude in X axis like this. Let's say we have two edges scale in y-axis. So now I will select all these faces, and in the x-axis will extrude like this. And as you can see, there is a remaining part. We can select this face and move in the axis like this. The next step is to make this USB this part. So it's very simple by making, let's select these two faces, cursor to selected, and in this right view I will start by adding a plane and the scale 0.01 and the scale 0.5. Still needs some scaling, so after that we'll scale in y-axis like this. So the next step is extruding in x-axis. And then we'll add loop cut and bevel. Let's try bevel again, and another two loop cuts and scale in y-axis like this. Then take or select this face and extrude in x-axis like this. And we can now move to the final part. So the final part, which is here, as you can see, nothing here is smoothed. So the next step is to making this let's say it cylinder or metallic cylinder. So in this position I will add an cylinder, and this cylinder will be has 12 and 0.01 and radius 0.01. let's scale shift y like this, and let's see, and scale another time. Moving in y-axis, and scale another time. We can apply rotation and scale to this object, and select this cylinder, mirror modifier, mirror around this, and the mirror, let's select it correctly. And as you can see, we haven't applied rotation and scale, so now we have this in the another side. The next step, I will select all these faces and shift D in X axis separate by selection, select all and scale in X axis like this. Then I will select all and extrude in X axis. Select this and extrude in x-axis, and then I will make a track which is here. So control R, control B, add a loop cut here, and add another loop cut here. Select these two faces and bridge edge loops. In this front view we will scale in the axis like this. Scale on the axis like this. We can refine this by scale in the axis and refine this one by scaling in the axis. And finally, let's see. And finally, we will mirror this in the another direction, but firstly, I will make this USB. So we have done it here, shift D in X axis like this. Then I will make a loop cut here and will duplicate and move to this layer, and now we'll select all this and delete. Select this vertex and make the origin to 3D cursor, and then I will mirror in Y axis. To make a clean geometry, we'll let's say clipping, and we'll a knife tool like this. We can subdivide it two times, and the next step is to select this and join. And I think the problem is that it this face isn't joined correctly. So I will select these two ones and Alt M merge at center, and this two vertex, and Alt M, I think. Now I will fix by Alt M at last. Alt M at last. Then let's move to the next part. We can delete all these faces and. Here is the same problem, I think, and we'll merge this at center. So I will pause the video and until I fix this problem. So I have fixed the problem, and as you can see, it now if you have made a loop, it it can be done without any. Without any issue. So now let's unhide all parts. After making the geometry, it now a blocking. It can be close to the shape, but now we will make the geometry to be smooth axis. So I will select all and shift D in the axis, move to layer, let's say this layer, and now I will add a subdivision surface and to be a smooth. making a loop cut here, making a loop cut here, and the next is to make a loop cut here, making a loop cut Alright, so we have now make this first and to this small shapes we can add also subdivision surface, or let's try the bevel modifier. Bevel modifier of 1 millimeter. Let's say it. And shading to be smooth, and it can work without adding a subdivision surface. Let's say it will be like this. So let's move to the next part. Now we have this part which is a connection. Let's add a subdivision surface and shading to be smooth, and also we can make or adding some loop cuts like this. And let's move to the next part. So this is the next part. As you can see, let's add subdivision surface. We can isolate this like this and apply smooth shading. Add loop cut here, another loop cut here. We can so as you can see, this the shape is similar, but we are wanting to make the surface which is here to be more round. So I will select this and move like this. Select this vertex and move like this. And select this and move not only that, but I will select this and scale in y axis. Let's see 0.8 and scale this to be 0.9. Scale in y 0.9. So we have made this part, and the next part to make is this shape. It has been done, but we will add a subdivision surface of 3 levels, and in the tool shelf we can make a smooth shading, and after that we can add a loop cut in this part, and adding a loop cut here. Let's isolate it and see what happens here. And as you can see, we have this in gun, and we can delete this face and select all select this vertex and extrude in y-axis. Then we can fill this face. Let's see, and the next and I'm now adding some edge loops like this. Alright, and let's see the opening here. It can highly, so I will select and scale in the axis like this. This scale by 0.7. Then also for this we can add select this and extrude scale shift y 0.5 at subdivision surface. And now we are done. For this we can scale in the axis and apply subdivision surface, isolate, and apply smooth shading. Also for this one is typical to this one, so apply subdivision surface smooth shading, and so now we have done the geometry. In the next part we will see how to render and applying texture to this cable.